Everyone, welcome to another episode of Torio Rapido's Math Tutorials. In this video, I'm going to discuss special products. In this video, we shall observe an orderly trick that allows us to identify patterns involved in multiplying a pair of binomials. By recognizing such patterns, expanding such products can be done more efficiently without lengthy calculations that could possibly create more confusion. And these patterns are called special products. So I'll be discussing three special products. So one special product is the product of the sum and difference of two numbers, wherein when you multiply the sum, let's say the numbers are x and y, and their difference. So by applying distributive property, so we will be getting a pattern of product in such a way that the product is simply the difference of the square of the first and the square of the second. And this product is what we call difference of two squares. So when you multiply sum and difference of two numbers, so the product is always a difference of two squares. And the pattern is just you square the first, meaning you multiply the first term by itself, and then minus multiply the second term by itself. So it's like squaring the first term minus squaring the second term. Okay? Next special product that I'm going to discuss in this video is the square of a binomial. Wherein we have here the square of the sum, and we have the square of the difference. So again, if we're going to apply the distributive property of multiplication, wherein this square means that you're going to multiply x plus y by itself two times. Also, x minus y by itself two times. So if you will repeat the process of multiplying a binomial by itself, so you will come across with the pattern. So this is our pattern for letter A. So the square of this binomial x plus y is a perfect square trinomial. So the product is a perfect square trinomial. Wherein the first term, so again x plus y square is a perfect square trinomial, wherein the first term is the square of the first term of the binomial. And then plus, if the binomial is a sum, plus twice the product. So we have here twice the product of the first and the second term, which is 2xy. And then plus the square of the last term, which is y. So we have here y squared. So this is the pattern in squaring every binomial. And for the second binomial here, so the only difference is the sign of the middle term. So the square of x minus y. So same pattern, you square the first term, but this time we have a negative sign for the middle term, since here we have a difference of two numbers. So we have here again difference, then twice the product of the first and the last, and then plus the square of the last term. So this is the pattern for the square of a binomial. So later I'm going to discuss this one by one in details. Next, we have special product number 3. So we have here cube of a binomial. So how do we get the product of a cube of a binomial? So the first pattern is for the cube of the sum of two numbers. So the cube of a binomial is a polynomial with four terms, wherein the first term is simply the cube of the first term. And then if we have sum of a binomial, then the sign in its expansion are all positive. So we have here plus thrice the product of the square of the first, and we have the second term. So here we have 3x squared y. And then again, plus thrice the product of the first and the square of the last. So we have here 3xy squared. Then finally, the last term will be simply the cube of the last term, which is y cubed. And for the difference, cube of the difference of two numbers, so again we follow the same pattern. The only difference that the signs of the terms are alternate, meaning we have positive first term, then negative second term, and again positive third term, and again negative last term. So this is the pattern for the cube of a binomial. So let us discuss each of these special products in details, and I'll be giving enough examples for you to understand the special products. So first, again, we have the product of the sum and difference. Of two numbers. Two numbers or two terms. Okay? So again, the product of the sum and difference of two numbers, okay, has the pattern x plus y times x minus y equals x squared minus y squared. So this is the pattern after we apply distributive property. So let us multiply this two binomial by applying distributive property or the FOIL method that we know. So FOIL method first. So product of the first terms. So we have x times x. Then we have the product of the last terms. And then we have the product of the inner terms and product of the outer terms. So we're going to get the product of this. So we have first term. We have x times x by log exponent 1. We have here x squared. And then here we have product of inner terms. So x y times x is positive xy. And then the product of the outer term, so we have x times y is negative xy. And product of the last terms, y times negative y is equal to negative y squared. And simplifying this, here we have xy minus xy. This will be equal to 0. And what is left is x squared minus y squared, which is our pattern. So, to make an easier method here, or to have a shortcut, so just apply the pattern for the product of the sum and difference of two numbers, in which the product of the sum and difference of two numbers is simply the square of the first term minus the square of the second term. So let us have examples. So here let us find the product of the following. Number one, let's say we have 2x plus 3 times 2x minus 3. So please take note that for you to apply this pattern, the numbers should be the same. So the first term or first term should be the same. So here we have 2x and 2x. The second term must also be the same. So we have here 3 and 3. Of course, the only difference is their operation in bold. Okay, so first we have sum, and then we have second we have difference. So by applying this pattern, so our first term here is 2x. So by our pattern, just square the first term. So we have 2x squared. Then minus second pattern square the second term. So we have here square 3. So when we say square, so it means that we just multiply the numbers by itself. So here we have 2x times 2x. So 2 times 2 is 4. And x times x is x squared. Minus here we have 3 squared is 3 times 3, which is 9. Therefore, the product of 2x plus 3 and 2x minus 3 is 4x squared minus 9, which is a difference of 2 squares. Okay? So, more examples. Example number 2. Let's say we have 5m squared plus 7n times 5m squared minus 7n. So again, please check whether this is a sum and difference of two same numbers. So we have here 5m squared, 5n squared, first terms. Second term, we have 7n and 7n. And of course, the operation involves are sum and difference. So this is a sum and difference of two numbers. So the pattern is simply a difference of two squares. So you square the first. So we have here 5m squared square, then minus square the second. So we have 7n squared. Just square these terms. So here we have 5 square is 5 times 5, so we have 25. M square square or m square times m square, so by the first law of exponent, so just add the exponent. So we have 2 plus 2 is 4, so we have here m to the fourth. Or by power of a power, so this is a power of a power, so simply multiply this. So 2 times 2 is 4. Okay? And then minus, again, square 7n. So 7 square, which is 7 times 7 is 49. And then we have n square, so we have n square. So again, this is now the product of 5m square plus 7n and 5m squared minus 7n. So this is by product of the sum and difference of two same numbers. Another example. Example number 3. Supposing we have 6e cubed plus 4f squared times 6e cubed minus 4f squared. So again, this is a sum and difference of two numbers. So the product is simply the square of the first, which is 6e cubed squared, minus the square of the second, which is 4f squared, then square. Okay, just simplify 6e cubed squared. So let us square for 6. So 6 squared is 6 times 6, so we have 36. And by applying here power by power, so we'll just multiply the exponents 3 and 2 and copy the base e, so we have e to the 3 times is 6, so we have e to the 6. Then minus square 4, so we have 4 times 4 is 16. And then again, power of a power here, so 2 times 2, so we have 4. Then we have the base f, so we have f to the fourth. So again, this is now the product of 6e cubed plus 4f squared and 6e cubed minus 4f squared. So more examples. Sample number 4. Let's say we have a over 5 plus b over 9 times a over 5 minus b over 9. So let us get the product of these two binomials. So again, these two binomials is a sum and difference of two numbers. So the pattern here is, again, you square the first. So we have here a over 5 squared, then minus square the second, which is b over 9 squared. And get the square. So a square, so here we'll be applying the distributive property of exponents. So a square, and then we have 5 squared. So 5 squared is 5 times 5, which is 25. And minus b squared over 9 squared. So 9 times 9 is 81. So this is now, again, the product. A squared over 25 minus b squared over 81. So let us have example 5. Let us say we have negative 4c squared over d plus 6e square over f multiplied by negative 4c square over d minus 6e square over f. So let us verify whether these two binomials are sum and difference of two numbers. Okay. So first terms, we have negative 4c squared over d, negative 4c squared over d. Second term, 6e squared over f, 6e squared over f. And then we have here sum and difference. So this is a sum and difference of two numbers, wherein the product is simply equal to the square of the first. So we have here negative 4c squared over d, and then we square. Then minus the square of the second, which is 6e squared over f, then square. Okay, then we simplify. So here we have negative 4c squared square. So here we have negative 4 times negative 4 is positive 16. And again, by power away power here, c squared to the second is c to the 4 over d to the second is d square. And minus 6 square is 36. And e square to the second, so by power of a power again, so we have e to the 4th over f square, so we have here f square. And again, this is now the product. So this product is a difference of two squares. Okay, so I hope you learned the pattern for our first special product, which is the product of the sum and difference of two numbers, which is a difference of two squares. So this product is a difference of two squares. Okay, so let us now have the second pattern, which is the square of a binomial. So we have here the square of a binomial. So again, the pattern here is, if we have square of a sum, say we have x plus y square. So again, the product is a perfect square trinomial, wherein the first term is the square of the first term of the binomial. Then the second term, or the middle term, So if we have here sum, then we have here plus. So the middle term is simply equal to the product of the exponent 2 and the terms xy, or simply twice the product of the first term and the second term, which is 2xy, plus the square of the last term, which is y squared. And then for the square of a difference, which is x minus y squared, so this is simply equal to same pattern, but we have different sign for the middle term. So here we have x squared, then minus, since we have here difference 2xy, and then we have here plus y squared. Okay, so this is how we square a binomial. Square the first, then plus minus twice the product of the first and the second term, then finally plus the square of the last term. And we call this product, so this product is a perfect square trinomial. So perfect square trinomial. Okay, so let us have by examples. So find the product of the following, or simply find the square of the following. Say we have number one. Let's say we have 3x plus 4, then raised to the second power. So this is a square of a binomial. So let us follow the pattern. So the pattern says that you have to square the first term. So the first term here is 3x. So square 3x. And then since we have here sum, so the middle term is plus. So plus what? Plus twice. This is 2 times the product of the first and the second, which is 4. So here we have 2 times 3x, which is the first term, times 4, which is the second term. And then finally, plus the square of the last term or second term. So we have 4 square. And then we just simplify this. So 3 square or 3 times 3 is 9. X square is x squared. And then plus, here we have 2 times 3 is 6. Times 4 is 24. Then times x is 24x. And again, plus 4 square is 4 times 9. 4 times 4 is 16. So this is now the square of 3x plus 4, which is 9x squared plus 24x plus 16, which is a perfect square trinomial. Another example, number 2. Supposing we have 5m minus 2n squared. So let us apply the pattern for the second one. So again, this is a square of a binomial. But this time, here we have a difference of 2 numbers. So the only difference is the sign of the middle term. So here we have plus sign. So for the expansion of this binomial, so we have minus sign. So again, let us follow the pattern. So the pattern is, the first term is the square of the first term of the binomial. So we have 5m square. And minus, since this is minus. Minus twice, 2 times the product of the first and the second. Then finally, plus. So the last term of the square of a binomial is always positive. So here we have plus the square of the second term, which is 2n squared. And then we'll just get the simplified form of this. So 5 squared is 5 times 5, which is 25. M squared is M squared. Minus 2 times 5 is 10. Times 2 is 20. And then M times N is MN. And then plus 2 squared is 4. And N squared is N squared. And this trinomial is another perfect square trinomial. Okay? So let us have more examples. Example number 3. Supposing we have 6AB minus 7CD and then square. So let us find the square of this binomial. So let us follow the pattern. So the pattern says that you have 2 square the first term. So 6AB square. And since this binomial is a difference, so the middle term is minus. Minus twice the product of the first 6AB and the second 7CD. Then finally plus the square of the second term, which is 7CD square. So we simplify further. So we have 6 square is 6 times 6, which is 36. A square is A square. B square is B square. And minus multiply 2 times 6 is 12. Then times 7 is, we have 84. So again, 2 times 6 is 12, times 7 is 7 times 2 is 14, 7 times 1 is 7 plus 1 is 84. And then AB times CD, so we have here ABCD. Then plus square 7, so we have 7 times 7 is 49. Then square C is C square, square D is D square. And again, this trinomial is a perfect square trinomial, which is the square of 6AB minus 7CD. Okay? Two more examples. So let's say we have example number 4. Supposing we have 5x cubed minus, or let's say plus 6y cube, and then we square. So this is again the square of a binomial. So let's apply the pattern. So the square of a binomial is a perfect square trinomial wherein the first term is the square of the first term, the square of 5x cubed. And then, so since this is sum, so the middle term here is plus. Plus twice the product of this term and this term. So we have 2 times 5x cubed times 6y cubed. And then finally, plus the square of the last term or second term, which is 6y cubed squared. And we simplify. So 5 squared is 5 times 5. So we have 25. And here we apply power by power, wherein we just multiply 3 and 2. So that will become the exponent of x. Okay, so we have here x to the 6th power plus 2 times 5 is 10, and 10 times 6 is, so we have here 2 times 5 times 6. So here we have 10 times 6 is 60. And then x cubed times y cubed, so we just combine them. So we have x cubed, y cubed. And then plus the square of 6y cubed, so we have 6 squared is 6 times 6, so we have 36. And again, here, we apply power of a power. So there is exponent raised to another exponent. So we just multiply 3 and 2, which will be, or which will become the new exponent of y, which is 6. And again, this trinomial is a perfect square trinomial, which is from the square of the binomial 5x cubed plus 6y cubed. Example number 5. Let's say we have 7p to the pip plus 8q to the 6, and then we square. So let us simplify this. So again, just follow the pattern. We square the first term, so we have 7p to the pip, then square. Then plus, since we have here a sum. Twice, again two times, the product of the first and second term. So we have 2 times 7p to the pip times 8q to the 6. Then finally, plus the square of the last, which is 8q to the 6, then square. And again, we simplify. So 7 square is 7 times 7, 49. Again, here we apply power of a power, wherein you have just to multiply 5 and 2, which will become the new exponent of p. So we have p raised to 5 times 2 is 10, plus, so multiply this, so 2 times 7 is 14, and then times 8 is 112, or simply 7 times 8 is 56, and then twice 56 is 112. So we have 112, and then p to the 5th times q to the 6th, so just combine them, p to the 5th, q to the 6th, and finally square 8q to the 6th, so we have 8 square is 8 times h, which is 64, and q to the 6th square, so again by power of a power, so you multiply 6 and 2, so the product will become the exponent of q, so we have q to the 6 times 2 is 12, and finally we have now this trinomial, which is a perfect square trinomial. So again, that's how to square a binomial, wherein the pattern is simply, you will square the first term, then plus minus twice the product of the first and the second term, and then plus the square of the second term. And the product that is obtained from the square of a binomial is what we call a perfect square trinomial. Okay? Next, we have the last special product that I'm going to discuss in this video. So the third one is, we have the cube of a binomial. So we have two patterns for the cube of a binomial. So first, if we have the sum okay, of the binomial. So cube of the sum of a binomial is equal to, so the cube of a binomial is a polynomial with four terms, okay, wherein the first term is the cube of the first term of the binomial plus the second term is 3 times the product of the square of the first and the second plus 3 times the product of the first term and the square of the second term. Then finally, plus the cube of the last term. So this is the pattern. And then for the difference, for the cube of the difference of a binomial, so same pattern, so the only difference is the sign of the terms in the expansion. So the signs of the terms in the expansion is alternate, positive, negative. So we have here positive x cubed, then negative 3x squared y, and again positive 3xy squared, then negative y cubed. So this is the pattern whenever we raise a binomial to the third power or when we cube a binomial. So let us have examples. So let us find the cube of the following binomials. So let's start with number 1. So let's say we have 2x minus 3, then cube. So here, identify the first term and the second term. So since here we have a cube, so we follow this pattern wherein the signs are alternate positive, negative, positive, negative. Okay? So our first term here is 2x and second term is 3. So follow the pattern. So the pattern is the first term of the expansion of this binomial is the cube of the first term. So we have here 2x to the third. And since this is minus, so alternate sign. So here we have positive and then negative what? So we have 3 times the square of the first, which is 2x squared, and then times the second term, which is 3. And then plus, again, plus 3 times. We have the first term, which is 2x, times the square of the second term, which is 3 squared. And then minus, we have the cube of the last term, which is 3 cubed. Okay? So again, cube the first minus 3 times the product of the square of the first and the second plus 3 times the product of the first and the square of the second minus the cube of the second term. So we just simplify this. So 2 cubed means 2 times 2 times 2, which is 8. X cubed, so we have here x cubed. And then here, so we simplify this first. So 2 squared, so that is equal to 4. And then we multiply 3 by 4 is 12. And then times 3 is 36. So we have here minus 36. And then the square of x, so we have x squared. So again, so here we first square 2, which is 4. So 2 squared is 4. Multiply the coefficient, so we have 3 times 4 is 12, times 3 is 36, okay? And then we have x squared. And then plus, so here first we square 3. So 3 squared is 9. And then multiply these numbers, okay? So here we have 3 times 2 is 6, times 9 is, okay, so we have 54, and then we have the variable x. And then finally, the cube of 3, which is 3, times 3 is 9, times 3 is 27. So this is now the expansion of, or the cube of 2x minus 3. Okay, so 4 terms, so we have 8x cubed minus 36x squared plus 54x minus 27. So let us have another example. Example number 2. Supposing we have a plus 2b and then q. So again, let us expand this binomial. So follow the pattern. So the first term is the cube of the first. It's a cube. So since it's a sum, all signs of the terms in expansion are positive. So we have here plus 3 times what? The square of the first and the second term. Plus, again, 3 times the first, then this time the square of the second. And then plus the cube. 2b, the cube of the second term. Okay, so that is our pattern in cubing a binomial or in raising a binomial to the third power. So let us simplify. So a cube, so we have here a cube. And then a square, so a square, multiply this by 3 and 2b. So 3 times 2 is we have 6. And then a square times b, so just combine them. So a square b. Then plus, so here we have 2 square first. So 2 square is 4. And then times 3, so we have 12. We have here 12. And then a times b square. So we have a b square. And then finally, we have here 2 cube. So 2 cube means 2 times 2 times 2. So we have 8. And then we have b cube. So we have b cube here. And again, this is now the expansion of a plus 2b to the third power. So let us have a third example. Supposing we have 3m minus 2n and then to the third power. So let us expand this binomial. So follow the pattern. So the first term will be the cube of the first term of this binomial. So we have 3m cube. And since this is minus, we have alternate signs. So positive first, and then negative second. So we have minus what? So again, our 3. So 3 times the product of the square of the first. So we have 3m squared. And the second, 2n. And then plus, alternate. So we have positive, negative, positive again. 3 times the first. And the square of the second. And then finally, minus the cube of the second term. And then we simplify this. So 3m cubed is 3 cubed times m cubed. So 3 times 3 times 3 is 27. Then we have m cubed. And then, so here let us have 3 square first, so 3 square is 9. So 3 times 9 is 27. And then times 2 is 54. So we have here minus 54. And then we have m square times n. So we have m square n. Plus So here, we square first 2. So 2 square is 4. And then 3 times 3 is 9. Okay. And then times 4, so we have 36. Then m. And then we have n square. And then finally, minus 2n cubed. So cube first 2. So 2 cubed is 2 times 2 times 2, which is 8. And then we have n cubed. So we have here n cubed. And again, this is now the expanded form of 3m minus 2n cubed. Okay. So last 2 examples. So let's have example number 4. Okay, let's say we have 2 minus, let's say, m. 2 minus m, then cube. So let us expand this. So again, the pattern is cube the first. And since this is minus or difference, we have here alternate sign. So this is positive first and then negative yung second term. So we have here 3 times. Okay, the product of the square of the first and we have the second term. Then plus 3 times the first term and the square of the second term, and finally minus the cube of the second term. So this is, so 2 cubed is 2 times 2 times 2, which is 8, and minus, so 2 squared is 4, and then times 3, so we have 12m, plus 3 times 2 is 6, then times m squared, so we have 6 m squared, then finally minus m cubed is m cubed. And then let us have example number 5 for the cube of binomial. Supposing we have 2x plus 3y raised to the third power. So again, let us cube this binomial. So the pattern is you cube the first, and since this is a sum, so all signs in the terms in its expansion are all positive. So we have here plus 3 times the product of the square of the first. Then we have the second. And plus 3 times the first. And this time the square of the second. And then finally plus the cube of the second term. And then again we just simplify. So 2x cubed is 2 cubed times x cubed. So 2 cubed is 8. And x cubed is x cubed. So we have 8x cubed plus. So 2 squared is 4. This is 4. So 3 times 4 times 3. So we have 36. And then x squared. So we have x squared. And then y. Plus, this time we have, so this 3 square is equal to 9. And then we multiply the coefficients. So 3 times 2 is 6, times 9 is 54. And then we have the variable. So we have x times y square is xy square. Then finally, we have 3y cubed, so we have 3 cubed is 27, and y cubed is y cubed. And this is now the expanded form of 2x plus 3y raised to the third power. And these are the special products that are discussed in this video. So again, first we have the product of the sum and difference of two numbers, wherein the product is a difference of two squares. So again, you will just square the first minus square the second. Next is we have the square of a binomial, wherein when we expand this square of binomial, so the product is a trinomial, which is a perfect square trinomial. Okay, so the pattern is you square the first, then plus minus twice the product of the first and second, then plus the square of the second term. And finally, we have the cube of a binomial. So I hope you learn a lot from this video tutorial. So watch out for my upcoming video. So we will extend this cube of binomial, so to the fourth power, to the fifth power, and that special product is what we call a binomial expansion. So wait for that video of mine. Okay, so again, thank you for watching and God bless everyone.